男仔啊，
唔緊要，係你媽咪托我問。
Celebrations in Hong Kong and around the world as people ring in the New Year. And a New Year's warning from North Korean leader Kim Jong-un.
Let's give her our support. Let's encourage her to quit smoking.
The world will be different if you're willing to share. It's a beautiful thing to share life by giving blood. One blood donation can save three or more lives. Share life, give blood. You can do it.
Everyone can choose their pathway, straight or curved. There's no need to follow others. Make your own choice.
Vocational and professional education and training covers a wide range of occupations and includes relevant programs up to degree level. It provides practical training to better prepare the younger generation for their future careers and helps them to enter a profession. VPET, leading you to a professional pathway.
From the 1st of May 2017, the statutory minimum wage is raised to $34.50 per hour. Employees covered by the minimum wage ordinance are entitled to this rate regardless of their mode of employment. Employees with disabilities can opt for assessment and receive wages according to the productivity assessed. For details, please call 2717-1771 or visit the Labor Department website.
The vision of Hong Kong 2030 Plus is to make Hong Kong a more livable, competitive, and sustainable metropolis. First, people-centric planning for a livable, compact city. Second, diversifying our economy and embracing new challenges. And third, enhancing development and environmental capacity for sustainable growth. Share your views on or before April 30th.
边个啊？
我系法团通告，通知你嚟紧要请新嘅清洁同保安公司，仲要做外墙维修。你系业主，要俾咁多。你唔知咧，因为你冇出席法团会议咯。
Building owners are responsible for managing the common parts of a building. Owners should attend meetings of the owners' corporation and vote on major issues in person to safeguard their own interests. Active participants
put on a spectacular show last night to ring in the new year. More than 360,000 people watched the annual fireworks display on both sides of Victoria Harbor. Naomi Leung reports.
A bright start to 2018. Perhaps brighter than ever this year, as the fireworks show covered a larger display area. Magical stardusts illuminated the Hong Kong skyline. Inspired by dancing fairies scattering magical dust, the scene used fireworks from a European award-winning firm. Spectators were left in awe. The 10-minute show wrapped up with shapes of smiling faces and red hearts, blessings of happiness and love. Spirits were high over in Lan Kwai Fong and people partied both inside and outside bars. night gun ceremony continued a tradition from 1946. A more solemn way to ring in the new year at Tai Po's Qishan Monastery with wishes for Hong Kong's prosperity and world peace. About 1,500 Buddhists join a ritual to search for inner peace. But there's no hiding the excitement from this couple. Their first child was born at midnight at Matilda International Hospital.
He was due on the 23rd of December, so we thought he was going to be a Christmas baby, but he had other intentions. So he obviously wanted to surprise us, being midnight born.
Two other babies at Baptist Hospital were also born at midnight. Elmi Long, TVB News.
Well, there were colorful New Year celebrations in other parts of the world as well. Jeff Tang recaps things by beginning in the Big Apple, which saw the second oldest New Year's Eve in its history.
New Yorkers and tourists braved the bitterly cold Arctic air mass to await the famous ball drop at the stroke of midnight. Despite the mercury hitting a low of minus 12 degrees, authorities estimated 2 million people were packed in the vicinity of Times Square to witness the century-old tradition. That's roughly the same number as last year, when the temperature was a much less frigid 7 degrees. The coldest ball drop on record was minus 17 degrees in 1917. Authorities spent $7.5 million to protect the event, as New York remains one of the biggest terrorist targets in the world. Partygoers in the southern hemisphere enjoyed much warmer weather, with temperatures hovering in the mid-20s in Rio de Janeiro. More than 2 million people welcomed 2018 at the city's famous Copacabana beach. In Europe, London's famous Big Ben rang in the new year as Brits were treated to a spectacular fireworks display along the River Thames. Over in the German capital of Berlin, the New Year's party took place under tight security at the Brandenburg Gate. At least 1,600 officers were on duty, 2 years after hundreds of women fell victim to groping and theft at celebrations in Cologne. The world's tallest building once again served as the focal point of celebrations in Dubai. But instead of the traditional fireworks, authorities decided to showcase a massive light show along the east side of the Burj Khalifa. That's partly due to safety following a massive skyscraper fire on New Year's Eve in 2015. In Beijing, large crowds gathered to bid farewell to 2017 at a special countdown ceremony at the Yongding Gate. The landmark, built during the Ming Dynasty, was the former front gate of Beijing's old city wall. Across the strait, Taipei welcomed the new year with a fireworks show of the city's tallest building, the 101. Australians were among the first to reach 2018. One of the highlights of their celebration was a rainbow waterfall cascade of light and colour flowing off the iconic Sydney Harbour Bridge to celebrate the recent legislation of gay marriage in the country. Jeff Tang, TVB News.
Well, North Korean leader Kim Jong-un has kicked off the new year with a warning for the United States. In an annual address, Kim said his country's nuclear forces are no longer a threat, they are a reality. But he also struck a conciliatory towards South Korea. It was a New Year's message, North Korean style. In the customary annual address broadcast on state-run media, Leader Kim Jong-un mixed New Year's greetings with a warning. Kim boasted that his country has achieved the historic feat of completing its nuclear forces, and added he has a nuclear button on his desk. He added he is ready to use it if Korea is threatened. Kim said the U.S. can never start a war against North Korea because the entire U.S. mainland is now within nuclear strike range. The annual New Year's address from Pyongyang is watched closely for indications of the direction and priorities Kim may adopt in the year ahead. Kim also stressed North Korea's economic achievements during the speech and noted the importance of improving the nation's standard of living. Kim also said he was open to dialogue with Seoul and may send a North Korean delegation to the Pyeongchang Winter Olympics as part of efforts to lower tensions on the Korean Peninsula. He said the games would be a good opportunity to showcase the status of the Korean nation and that he sincerely hopes the event will be held with good results. This year's speech was seen as particularly important because of the high tensions over Pyongyang's frequent missile launches and a recent nuclear test. The tests were the focus of fiery verbal exchanges between the North and U.S. President Donald Trump, who has called Kim Little Rocket Man. Asked for his reaction to Kim's remarks about having a nuclear button on his desk, Trump responded,
We'll see.
Meanwhile, South Korea's presidential office said today it welcomes the proposal to hold talks about the possibility of North Korea sending a delegation to the Olympics. President Moon Jae-in's office said the event should contribute to peace and harmony, not only on the Korean Peninsula and in Northeast Asia, but in the entire world. The CEO of one of the world's biggest food service companies was among the five British tourists killed when a seaplane crashed during a 20-minute flight yesterday. Australian authorities are still working to salvage the wreckage from waters just north of Sydney.
The plane is sitting in relatively deep water, but it's not an insurmountable operation for us. We will have the divers attend the scene. We have, in the course of this investigation already, been in contact with the UK, and we believe, in fact we can confirm, that the persons involved in this matter, along with the pilot, were visitors from overseas.
One of the tourists was identified as Richard Cousins, the CEO of British food service company Compass Group, who was due to retire at the end of March. The others killed include his two sons, his fiancée and her daughter, as well as the plane's pilot. Australian Prime Minister Malcolm Turnbull offered his condolences to the families of those killed. Police dive crews are working to refloat the wreckage. The plane belonged to a company that has flown tourists around Sydney on seaplanes the last 80 years. All of its flights are suspended until further notice. Back locally, new year, new prices. Starting today, many services will cost you a little more. Here again is Elmi Moon.
If your new year resolution includes spend less, save more, you might be disappointed. Higher electricity bills came into effect today after the two power companies raised tariffs by 1.9% due to higher operating costs and fuel prices. CLP Power now charges $1.15 per unit of electricity, while Hong Kong Electric charges $1.13. A new 0.04% levy rate applies to most insurance policy holders, old or new. The levy will be collected by insurance providers for the insurance authority to fund its operations. Car owners will pay 6% more in monthly rental at parking lots under the housing authority. The measure affects 30,000 spaces at over 150 car parks at public housing estates. Sheltered spaces will see fees as high as $2,730 a month, open ones at $2,250 max. Be prepared to pay a little extra for your mail. Local mail under 30 grams now costs $2 to send out. Buy air just under $5 to deliver to overseas destinations like the UK, US and Canada. Elmi Long, TVB News.
More than 70,000 secondary school students have named their top news items of 2017. Sharon Tanning tells us what made the list.
And the top 10 news items of 2017, according to Hong Kong students, goes to Carrie Lam becoming Hong Kong's first female chief executive. In second place, Typhoon Hato, which brought death and destruction to Macau. And coming in third place, the fatal accident at the Haunted House attraction in Ocean Park. All this was the result of 70,000 students from 137 local secondary schools taking part in the survey. Some pupils, however, did not see their top 10s make the final cut.
Local
One of the international news items on his list, but did not make it, was the Catalan independence movement. Among the four international news items which made the top 10 2017 was the Las Vegas mass shooting and the Manchester Arena bombing. For the 26th consecutive year, the organization has spotted yet again a new trend of how secondary students receive and respond to news stories. Organizers both said that instead of watching the news on traditional media channels, students read stories immediately when witnesses upload photos and videos to social media platforms. Meanwhile, the escalator accident in Mong Kok was ranked 9th, and the controversy over the basic competency assessment for primary 3 students rounded up the top 10. Sharon Tang, TVB News.
Finally, a quick look at the weather. We'll be sunny periods for tomorrow, with temperatures ranging between 17 and 20 degrees. That's our time for the news. Thanks for joining us. Good night.